So far, our units have focused on showing that problems are hard, or NP-complete, to be more precise. Actually, what I have very often observed in practice, and even in scientific papers where the authors did not have a solid background in theoretical computer science, is this. Once a problem is shown to be NP-complete, many people will just tend to give up, or come up with some, well, honestly terrible algorithm that they justify with, well, the problem was NP-complete. And that is why we're now going to turn our attention to countermeasures against NP-completeness. So this unit and the following units are your first aid kit to help you overcome NP-completeness, or at least take a bit of the sting out of them. Because imagine you find yourself in a situation like the four computer scientists that we have gotten to know throughout this course, like Alice, Bob, Carol, and Dave. Solving tough problems was part of their job. Alice was solving vertex cover for telecommunications. Bob was working in biotech, developing new medicines, analyzing genes. Carol was working in finance, designing secure investments. And Dave was working in logistics, where he had to solve the shortest tour problem. And actually, there are logistics companies who develop algorithms with which they save millions every day, and also fuel. So those problems are practically relevant, although they are NP-complete. So when your company or your boss asks you to solve an NP-complete problem, what should you do? Should you say, I want another problem? Should you make her or him take this course so that they finally understand NP-completeness? Should you say, it's impossible to do that? Should you say, it's proven impossible? Or should you say, it's proven difficult, but we can try?